couple of quick shout outs. One is for Model Pro 72. This guy is a legend. What he can't do with styrene and a bit of glue ain't worth mentioning. Next one goes out to Freddy Fernando Doughty. Yeah, you're going to have to say that on one of your videos. But yeah, this guy's an absolute legend. And got some absolute awesome builds and kits. You really need to look at some of his armour. Fantastic work. Really, really good. Looking forward to seeing more from him. And this guy, making models again. I'm speechless over some of the work he does. Tiny, tiny little models. And you get so much detail. And scratch building is second to none. Not to mention his videos are really entertaining. Definitely one I'd recommend. This guy is awesome. Right, so last week you'll remember that I was building this particular model kit. And amongst all my web developing and copy and pasting content and designing logos and all that kind of fun, I found time to get her built and painted and the main decals applied. There's some of the finer stenciling that still needs to go on, and the sidewinders, they've got some stenciling that needs to go on those. And then they can be applied. But I'd say she's 95% of the way there. So without further ado, I will present my BAe Hawk T Mark 1A, which is the ground attack and local air defence variant of the Hawk T Mark 1. The actual model build went together really, really well. No real areas to highlight as problem areas. No, none at all. The only thing I would say is last week I commented on the texture of the plastic, that there was a kind of silky feel to the plastic, made with very, very fine indentations in the plastic. Just gave it a feel of quality. However, as you can see from the box art, the Black Hawks are a very high gloss. Achieving that on a textured surface is near impossible. There is some shine there, but nowhere near. There we go, you can see some. Nowhere near the level that's on the box art. So, there we go. The specific Hawk that I chose to model is one of the ones that, one of the two, in fact, that are based at RNAS or RAF Yeovilton in Somerset. That's my current local airfield. That said, it's about 30-odd miles away. But yeah. One of the things I didn't realise until building this model is I knew that the Hawk was small, but I didn't realise either how small or how big it is compared to something like the... the canopy has fallen off. The A10. stick that back up later. But yeah, the A10 tank buster is huge in comparison. Now, I used to live in Cambridgeshire, right between RAF Witton, which had Hawks, and RAF or USFE Alconbury, which had A10s. And I used to see them flying over on a daily basis and never quite realised the difference in size. The A10's twice the size of the Hawk, but the A10s are so manoeuvrable and thrown around the sky that you just don't appreciate the size difference. But yeah, anyway, that's a bit of trivia for you. Now, Thursday or Friday, I can't remember what day it was, I received something quite exciting in the post by way of a part resolution to an issue that I had with an Airfix model kit. That model kit being the... The 124 scale Spitfire Mark VB kit number A50141. It's a really old kit and the mouldings are 40 odd years old, and there were just so many issues with the build, and lots of other people a lot more experienced than me have also had issues with the build. Quality, parts just not fitting correctly. All of the engine covers seem to fit badly. So I wrote off to Airfix and explained my issues and explained the parts that weren't fitting correctly and asked them whether there was any chance that they might be doing a new version of it, a retooling, and the likelihood is that they won't, which is a shame. But instead they sent me a replacement kit, which was the same one, exactly the same kit with exactly the same issues, which didn't really resolve anything. So I wrote back and said I was happy to send back that kit, as it didn't resolve any issues, and could they possibly send me an alternate kit? They replied and said that they're working on the Spitfire. I don't know what that means, whether they're replacing some parts or a complete retooling, but they're going to try to resolve the issues regarding the 124 scale Spitfire. But in the meantime, they've sent me this kit, which was really good of them. And that's the 148 scale Spitfire PR XIX, which is a photo reconnaissance version, so it has no armament. It's a new tooling, which was the reason they sent it. They wanted to demonstrate that their new toolings are brilliant, and it certainly looks brilliant, and I will do a full inbox review on it in the next couple of days. But anyway, that's enough from me. It was just a quick update to let you know where I was with the Hawk. With the Hawk, I'll let you see it. And that's it from me. Have a great weekend, everybody.